Hi, this is UseWise channel. You're watching the second part of the video, Google Drive versus OneDrive versus your good old hard drive. We are continuing the conversation where we left off. Many companies behave toward their data as we personally do toward our hard disk for most of the time. And companies would invest lots of money into network attached storage or in other ways to share files within the company just to keep them inside. Can you tell us more about that and how companies can really make their lives much easier?
Mm-hmm. So, of course, if companies enable their employees to use cloud-based storage like Google Drive and OneDrive, suddenly there will be enablement of their workforce for collaboration. They will be able to securely and easily share their data and work together on that data. And if they close their company into silos and try to build kind of a their own treasury instead of having instead of using bank services, then of course they'll run a risk of having to protect their treasury. They'll have quite a big investment in that, and they will never be able to achieve same level of protection and of service that is possible if they are using Google Drive or OneDrive services for their employees. So today most people have to work with mobile phones, with notebooks, and they need access to their data. So if you have network attached storage and stuff like that, most probably you'll have to run VPNs, you'll have to run old authentication schemes and stuff like that. So that is very expensive and poses more and more risk. So if now it's really a good time to move to cloud drives. So Google Drive and OneDrive are two of best of the breed services.
Yeah, and also when we talk about storing large amounts of data on GCP, on Azure, on AWS, it can also be done. You really do not need to have your local storage, you do not need to invest in that. You can just take advantage of the public cloud and of the services provided. Can you give us some insight into that?
Yeah, so with a cloud drive, since it's kind of an object storage, you get additional benefit that you can use search results to organize your drive. You can have multiple labels attached to your documents, your files, and there is no... You can store very big files and a huge number of files. So if you are storing terabytes of archiving documents, it's quite often very well suited for Google Drive or OneDrive services. So many people are starting using that benefit. Of course, there are some limitations. So in order to protect their services, both Google and Microsoft basically prevented users from using cloud drives as a content distribution network, so that you would put movies and stuff like that and then stream from their services, but you can store your video files, you can store other big files without an issue, and you can have tens of thousands of files that are very fast to access and that are searchable, so you get even more benefits
And we are trying to use this channel as a vessel where we can show you that this new world is possible. Many companies are still struggling with trying to maintain the old world when the old world is in fact going away, and the faster it will go away, the better you will be to start using new services. So we wanted to make this video to show you some of the glimpses into the possibilities that are brought to you by the public cloud, and how what you have always believed in and what you have always considered as the safe option might not be so safe after all. We are multi-cloud, so we can give you advice for your specific situation, whether Google Drive, OneDrive will be a better option for you. There are also some other providers that can give you this type of service outside of Microsoft and Google. Can you tell us more about that?
Yeah, so there are many, many cloud storage services and even different types. But Google Cloud Drive and Microsoft OneDrive are part of a whole bundle of office productivity applications, and they are best suited for most enterprises and for most employees. Of course, if you have some special needs, there are niche players, and there are a number of solutions that go beyond capabilities of Google Drive and OneDrive, but they are outside of the scope of most users.
Yeah, most users will be using definitely Microsoft or Google, since they have the largest office productivity suites, and many people are just in a situation where they find them most easily accessible, very easy to use, and it is
they come in also Google Drive and OneDrive come in number of flavors. They can be used for personal storage, but they can also be organized so that you can manage group storage or company storage.
Mm-hmm.
And there are a number of ways how you can license them. So you can buy personal storage, or your company can buy manageable storage licenses and assign them to the users, or you can even go for unlimited storage, meaning basically that you can store as much data as you would like with as many files as you would like.
Mm-hmm.
for all of your employees. So there are many choices, and we are here to help optimize solutions for you. And
because there are basically no one-size-fits-all solutions. We always try to tailor the solution to your needs. Thank you so much, Mladen, for giving us your insight. Please contact us if you would like to learn more. There is a link to the feedback form in the description of the video, so leave us your feedback. You can also book your appointment slots with us to have a one-on-one conversation about your needs, and have a great day. Take care. Thank you so much. Bye.
Take care. Bye.
Bye.